Hey guys, David Kwan here. So this video, I'm pretty much going to talk about all things Final Fantasy XIII. It's a game with a lot of, it's loaded with controversy, a lot of discussions, and it certainly has a lot of hate, and that's the sound of some of my video conversions being done. But yeah, suddenly like, it's a pretty interesting game to talk about in that regard, and there's a lot to talk about with this game, so I don't know if I'm going to make multiple videos on this game, or if this video will be it. I'll just talk and see what happens with this. But yeah, Final Fantasy XIII, where do I even begin? I'll start with the easy ones. The easy thing is, this game is beautiful. Like, graphically speaking, it's one of the most just eye-curlingly beautiful games I've ever played. It's like, For me, it was like watching Avatar, which is the movie that I consider as pretty much like it won best picture for I don't know what year it was in the Oscars, but totally deserves that just for the visual quality. The story of Avatar is pretty the script is like the writing is pretty cliche, and whatever. But Avatar for me was like that movie was just like, oh my gosh, this is a gorgeous movie, and me playing Final Fantasy XIII, most of it, like, just talking about graphics, just talking about, not graphics, but, like, the art style. The whole thing, I'm just like, wow, this is a really gorgeous-looking game. It's beautiful. It's so colorful. And that may be because I am used to so many games out there nowadays are games where the topic is kind of like the drudgery or the reality of war or, you know, just post-apocalyptic world where it makes sense, where the world is not colorful. Games like Fallout, Gears of War, Resistance, even compared to something like Uncharted where you are going into like jungles and stuff, but you're still mostly exploring caves, and kind of, you know, in that setting. And then there's Final Fantasy XIII, which just lights up crazy. It's, like I said, it's one of the most colorful looking games ever. There's a few sections in the game, big sections in the game, where you are inside, like, I don't want to say temple, but you are inside. The whole chapter 4 is kind of like this whole junkyard, so it's all brown. And then I think chapter 9, was it, or 10, you're inside this gigantic tower. It's mostly kind of grayish blue, but at the same time, I mean, the enemies you fight, the characters, their outfits, the world you travel in, the crazy technology you see, it's a very colorful game. There's a lot of different things here that just kind of just makes your eyes go boom, you know. So on that respect, Final Fantasy XIII is pretty like fantastic. Chapter 2 just had me going like, because that happens when, you know, they find out about Lassie, or the process of becoming Lassie, and then they find the crystallized form of Lightning Sister, who I forgot the name of, and then they get pulled in, and they get this tattoo, and then they wake up, and they find themselves, like, with this ocean frozen over, the frozen ocean, the ocean's crystallized, walking around that was beautiful, it's so gorgeous. So, in just terms of the environment, the kinds of enemies you fight, the art style, it's a wonderful looking game. It's still hard to find a game this generation that's as colorful. I'm trying to think of games more colorful. Really, not many are coming to mind. I mean, Uncharted is something that comes to mind, kind of. Other RPGs, really. Eternal Sonata, beautiful looking game. And I love the art style too. But Final Fantasy XIII is just one of those, it's like, to me, it's like Avatar, watching it, you know. When I watched Avatar, I didn't even watch it in 3D, but I should do that sometime. But when I watched it, I was just like gawking at the screen, just like, wow, this is a beautiful movie. Now, because this vlog, I'm not worried about talking about spoilers, I will probably talk mainly about story of Final Fantasy XIII, which I think is a really interesting story overall. I can understand why people grew to hate it, and certainly I can also understand why people grew to love it. There's a lot of different things here. It's kind of inconsistent in a lot of ways, but at the same time, there's a lot here. There's a lot of thematic value to Final Fantasy XIII's story, and I think that's really interesting. I've said in another blog about Final Fantasy XIII, it's that the characters in Final Fantasy XIII, I think, developed more so than in any other Final Fantasy game before it. Just seeing this, like Hope, for example, is really this whiny character who just kind of doesn't know what's going on, but it's just kind of like as a kid, and then he meets up with his father, and then there's that moment going on, and he grows to be this brave little guy who tries to fight. Seeing his transformation was pretty cool. Lightning's transformation into this, from this cold-hearted, not caring person who just only cares about her fiercely, like, path to free her sister and not caring about anything else. But then her coming to, you know, her being paired with Hope and then learning to nurture the kid, and then being like a mother figure or an older sister figure to this kid Hope, seeing that was really cool. Like, the transformations that these characters have are really cool. My least favorite character was Snow, obviously. He makes his coat is that heroes don't need a plan. He says that so many times. It's so aggravating to hear that line. Heroes don't need a plan. He just goes charging into the front lines of the enemy and with fists. He doesn't even have a fucking weapon. Like, what is this character? And why is he so, like, ridiculous? Just ridiculous. Over the top, just gets in there without thinking, because apparently heroes don't need to think. I hated this character, but even seeing him transform, actually just him explaining like why he is this way, you know, because when he's doing something, it helps him to not think about or dwell on the things that are painful to him. You know, just seeing these characters kind of move forward into that final moment where we have this cliche theme of everyone get together and fight together against this big old monster thing. Like, the theme, the ending conclusion to that, reaching there, it wasn't like a powerful moment, but seeing the process of how that happens in this game was, I think, one of the strongest points about this game, especially compared to the other Final Fantasy series. I compare this game story a lot to Final Fantasy X. There's a lot of similar themes going on here. The theme going, like, Final Fantasy X was all, the biggest theme going for it was fighting against tradition. Solving, like, this age-old thing, this monster beast, so now I'm kind of spoiling Final Fantasy X as well. So if you don't care about the spoilers of 10 and 13, this video is okay. If you do care, then you probably shouldn't be watching this. But yeah, 10, it was this age-old cycle of this gigantic beast called Sin. And it would periodically come, every 1,000 years or every 100 years, periodically come and destroy all civilization in it. And so that's a tradition that this society has, and it's become accepted. And it turns out the process of defeating Sin and becoming Sin is also a tradition that's become accepted. So these characters find out, and this is the common theme, is fighting against tradition. You know, how do we get rid of all this? Say no, because just because things have been the way they are, because they've always been the way that things are, shouldn't be that the way things are. Wow, that was a really worded sentence, but that's pretty much the theme of Final Fantasy X. These characters are going there, they find out the truth about tradition, and they try their best to eliminate the tradition. So Final Fantasy XIII, though, has also that theme of tradition. The Lassie, the Falci, controlling this universe, and I know the biggest problem with Final Fantasy XIII is this jargon. There's a lot of it. It makes talking about this game such a chore, so tedious. But yeah, they have these powers that rule the world, and anyone who becomes a Lassie is branded as a terrorist in this part of the world, whereas in this part of the world, you know, it's not so. So there's this labeling done by tradition, and so they don't know why they have become branded as terrorists, and constantly they're confused. So I think 13's theme is really great in that there is tradition, but the characters and the players are just totally confused about what that tradition actually is, why it has been going on this, what they're actually fighting for, what they're fighting against. It's such a mystery and such a confusion that it makes you doubt what you're doing as a whole. But then you're constantly pushing forward because you kind of think that's how you, that, you know, it, moving forward is at least better than, you know, waiting around and becoming a crystal or becoming one of those monsters. So that's also a very interesting concept that, you know, if you complete your mission, you become a crystal for eternity. Or if you don't complete whatever mission you're given, you turn into a monster of some sort. Either way, it's not great. You know, playing this game, I kind of, both 10, like 10 had a lot of allusions to religion. It can be kind of seen as a game whose message is against, is anti-religion. 13, if you think about it that way, it makes pretty powerful statement. It's probably, I don't know if this was the game writer's intention, but I am pretty anti-religious myself personally. So seeing in that lens, it was like, it was so powerful to see, like, hey, these are the two choices given to these characters. They either, you know, gets rewarded becoming a crystal for all eternity. You know, they look beautiful, but they become crystal. They don't have a life anymore. They're pretty much just stable, like, it's like cryo sleep for all eternity. Or they become this ugly looking monster that is always tormenting itself for not being able to complete its mission. So there are the two choices. And that kind of makes me think about how I think about heaven and hell. You know, in that way, it makes a pretty damn powerful statement against religion, and saying that religion doesn't give you a choice. You know, but that's a whole other topic altogether. So Final Fantasy 13, I think, has a lot of rich themes in there. I just think that some of the execution was pretty bad. The writing in this game is, like I said, all over the place. We have characters like Lightning and, gosh, this is gonna make me sound racist, but I forgot the name of the black character. Fuck. Saz, I think, was his name. And his quest to fulfill the mission of his son, who is like this, his main opposition now. He's the instrument of the group that's now tracking, like, that's labeled him as terrorist and is trying to track him down. And his son was used to track him down because his son has the ability to know the location of the lessee. Amazing stuff. And then to find out that his son's mission was to track him down, and then his son turns into a crystal. And then there's that moment when Saz puts that gun to his head and it's like, this is fucking awful, I'm going to kill myself. And he can't do it. That was, like, to see Saz develop from this, like, character who is doing everything he can because he's a father and because he loves his son. He wants to do his son's mission for him. But it turns out that his son's mission is actually something that's to his detriment. And then figuring out that, okay, his son completes the mission, but the end result is his son becomes a crystal. It's not any good. And then him just kind of losing it. And then just trying to watch him, like, just move on forward after that. It was quite a scene. I think that, to me, was one of the most powerful scenes in the entire game. And I know he's one of those controversial characters, like, you know, he's the only black character in Final Fantasy 13. And he kind of has something, he has a very stereotypical look about him. He has an afro, you know, he uses guns and, you know, his movements are kind of like gangster-ish, you know. So there's some controversy there, but at the same time, I feel like Saj as a character is one of the most interesting characters in Final Fantasy 13. So that was really cool. My least favorite character, as I said, is Snow, but even him develops into something that a serious side of him, as we see. I think if you can just stomach through the first parts of the characters, and then see how they change in the end into becoming stronger, more mature, more serious characters, Final Fantasy 13, when it starts to have that kind of a serious tone after all this confusion, as they start to, you know, discover more about themselves, it's been pretty interesting ride to see that. The main villain is weird. Like, the enemies that we're fighting against, it was the most confusing thing ever. That's probably like the biggest downer about Final Fantasy 13 is we don't really know who we're fighting against. And even at the end, when that guy goes into that pool and comes out at this weird gigantic monster thing, and that's the final boss fight, it's just like, what is that? And why is it fighting us? And, you know, it's so weird because in the other Final Fantasy games I played, at least it's very clear who the enemy is. 10 is the Sin. You know, very, very obvious. Like, from the beginning, we know it's Sin, and our job, and our fight is in our, and it's our job to confront that. And then it turns out it's actually the main character, Titus's father, that's actually Sin. But it's still very clear who the enemy is. It's actually still pretty clear who the enemy is in 12. I never played 6, but I'm pretty sure the enemy is clearly, you know, the clown guy. The guy in the clown costume. In 7, it was Sephiroth. Very clear villains, which makes the storytelling so strong in those games. There was a time I talked with a former coworker at a shelter, and we talked a lot of different things. He loves comic books, and he prefers Marvel over DC or is it the other way around? I don't know, I forgot. But one of the things he says is that a comic book hero, you know, a comic book about a hero is only as strong as how great the villain is. And so I think it was DC. I think he prefers DC because of, like, stuff like Batman. You know, where the villain feels human or just is crazy. You know, you have characters like the Joker and Mr. Freeze. You know, when you have strong villains in a comic book story, that's a strong comic book. That's the point he makes. And unfortunately, Final Fantasy 13, although it's not a comic book, but I think this point, same point still holds. The villain is, we don't even know who the villain is. So, does it have a strong villain? Obviously not. So that's one of the worst things about Final Fantasy 13's story, is that it doesn't really have a villain. Well, it does, but it's not clear who he is, what his motive is overall. What good did it do to have these characters be labeled as terrorists? And then just constantly have them be tracked down. Does he want to, like... It's weird. It's a weird storyline in that regard. The overall picture of Final Fantasy 13 is a very weird one. And one that I still... Maybe I need to replay it again. It's been a while, but... One that I still kind of can't grasp. With this jargon and its weird... like, entities that rule the world. The ending scene of the entire game is just a confusing mess. It's pretty to look at, but it's like, what the hell is going on? Like, why is this happening? Like, that's probably the biggest fault of Final Fantasy 13. I don't know what the fuck is going on, okay? That's a big problem. But I love the characters. They grew on me. I hated them in the beginning. Lightning especially, and Snow, oh my god. And that other female character who is kind of like, it reminds me a lot of Riku in Final Fantasy X, who's just kind of there, this naive girl. But she actually, like, her development as a character was actually really cool to see. But yeah, that's pretty much a lot of what I have to say about Final Fantasy 13, is that the story as a whole is pretty crappy writing, and it's everywhere. It's a mess. It's a mess of things that I do not understand. But I love the characters. I love how, like, I don't like the characters in the sense that I, you know, who they are or whatever, but I like the journey that they took. And the changes in life, it's all about, like, who we are becoming. It's this journey of learning more about ourselves. And, you know, Final Fantasy 13 is kind of like that. You these characters become more than who they like see themselves as. You know, they developed as something else, and they change and they evolve. Seeing that process was really awesome, and having to go through, like, you know, it was worth it to see that. You know, having to stomach through the awful design issues and the bad writing in some parts, having to stomach through just hating who Snow was in the beginning and just some of the annoying things about the characters. It was worth it in the end, just to see that development happen. And as I said, I was able to stomach a lot, largely due to the fact that it is a beautiful looking game. It is, like, I can't really knock its art style or anything, because at least to me, like, it looks so gorgeous. I mean, graphically, it's not the best graphical game. I mean, there's a lot of issues here and there. You know, polygon count, texture issues, lighting issues. But just looking at, like, just the picture aspect of it, it's a gorgeous looking game. So that had me able to stomach it and able to see these characters grow. I haven't played Final Fantasy XIII 2, but because of the fondness I developed for these characters, it makes me excited to pick up and play Final Fantasy XIII 2. And, you know, maybe depending on my opinion of that game, I might be actually glad that Final Fantasy XIII Lightning Returns is actually being made and coming out. I don't know. I have yet to decide on that because I haven't played Final Fantasy XIII 2. But yeah, that's pretty much my spoiler vlog on this game for now. I don't know if I'll make any more videos on Final Fantasy XIII. It is such a big game to talk about because of the surrounding controversy, but yeah.